launch the construction of 4 classrooms with 10 stances of VIP latrine in Mijale Primary School.
Four of the schools will get 2 classroom blocks each with 2 stances of toilets for both girls and boys, while 5 schools will get toilets. Mijale Primary School is one of the schools with high enrollment hosting refugees and host community children. The head teacher, David Okwonzi, welcomes the project but asks for more as the school enrollment overwhelms the number of available classrooms.
We have total enrollment of learners in Mijale Primary School as 2,286. In this, we have children who are refugees and also nationals. In Mijale Primary School, we don't have enough sanitary facilities for all these learners. We only have 2 VIP latrines of 5 stands each, and these are not enough for these learners. And we have 11 classrooms. These classrooms are not enough for these learners. All the learners are congested in these classrooms. We are very, very grateful to Safeford for having given for us classrooms, 4 classrooms, and 10 stances of VIP latrine.
The program manager, Safeford Mawa Steven Alatawa, believes the new classrooms will keep children in school.
The project is targeting children, education, especially children who have dropped out of school, and also encourage children who are in the school education system to provide both access and quality education to the children. The enrollment in this school is very immense. We have over 2,000 children enrolled in this school. And looking at the quality of the education, the pupil classroom ratio, pupil desk ratio, all these are one thing. But also above all, looking at the first structures that were put by the community when the school started as a community school, the structures are not dilapidated. They are unsafe for learning. Therefore, we are going to demolish the old structure and put a new modern classroom.
The education specialist Strome Foundation, Hannington Kumaketsi, reminds the school and parents to consider retention and completion as the key aspect of the project for the learners.
Most of the children drop out of school because they don't have good facilities in school. And it's not really very good for us to look at these challenges and don't support. So that's why Strome Foundation came on board with the support that they got from the donor, that's Educate a Child. So Educate a Child is giving us support to support in totality 128 schools, and out of these 128 schools, 32 are model schools. But in Yumbe district, we have 25 model schools, like I said before, but we also have 75 partner schools. The rest of the schools are in Obonge district. In Obonge district, we have 7 model schools and 21 partner schools.
The Rising Project aims to enroll 100,000 out-of-school children, especially girls in marginalized and refugee communities, in 9 districts of Uganda, including Yumbe district.
Yumbe District Education Officer Rasul Luriga explains the huge gap in the classroom pupil ratio.
The classroom ratio stands at 1 to 124. The classrooms we have built in history so far in Yumbe are 1,397 classrooms. So we have a total classroom gap of 3,200 classrooms.
You see that in most cases, the parents who are concerned about the children to be in school are women. And this is something that we must also look at and see that our young girls must be in school and get educated.
Robert Ariaka reporting for Urban News in Yumbe District, West Nile Region.